Assalamu alaikum dear students, my name is Mohammad Asif and in this video lecture series we are learning visual programming. Student, this is week number 7 and lecture number 12 and clip number 3. In our previous lecture we have learned about the inheritance concepts. We have also learned about the syntax and solve the programming example. And also we have learned about the multi-level inheritance, the syntax and solve a programming example. Inshallah, in today's lecture, we will be learning that how constructor will be used within the inheritance and will be solved with the help of programming example. Next, we will be learning that constructor in multi-level inheritance, that how constructor will be applied are used within the multi-level inheritance. It will also be solved with the help of programming example. So student, let's start our today's topic. Okay students, so first you will be learning that the constructor in inheritance. As already informed you about, we will be implementing the constructor in inheritance. So first, let me change the name of the class, that is, let's say A, and now class A is body is ended. Just declare me a specifier of a public and data type string, variable name is name. Now let's see, define a function having a constructor without return type. Let's say the name of the function will be A because the class name is A, having 0 arguments. Within this constructor we will be initializing the variable name, that is name is equal to name assignment operator. Let's say we have a Kadir, class body is just ended. Now let me define another class having name is B, and this class is connected with the parent class A. Within this class again we will be having a data type of integer, public specifier, and the variable name is marks. Public specifier, then again the function name will be B, mean the constructor function having 0 arguments. Again in this constructor we will be initializing marks variable. Marks is equal to, let's say his marks is, let's say 70. Okay, so this is how we have just created two classes. One is parent class, second one is the child class, and we have inherited the parent class within the child class. Within the parent class we have just declared one variable having data type of string and one constructor function, because the name of the function and name of the class is same, and within this constructor function we have just initialized the string variable with the Kadir value. Within the child class we have inherited class A, which is the parent class, and define integer data type of public specifier having name is marks, and initialize this marks within the constructor function, because the name of the function and name of the class is same, so having 0 parameters. So again these two constructors are by default parameter because they are having no parameters. So when we create the object for the child class, as we already did, let's see B, then OB is equal to new and B. So we have just created the object for B, which is a child class, but B is connected with a class parent, which is A. So first it goes to the class A. If there is any by default constructor, it will be called. So it will also be called. Then it will come back to the class B. Then it will call the second constructor, which is by default constructor. So in both cases, first the name will be initialized, and secondly the marks will be initialized. So at the end, let me print both these values, console.WriteLine, because these two variables are just initialized with the help of constructor function. So the name is equal to plus ob dot name. So with the help of ob, we call both these variables. We can call. So let's see again, console.WriteLine. Now let me call the second variable, which is marks. Marks is equal to concatenation. Again, same object, but the variable is now changed. So we have called these data members with the help of object and print with the help of write line function. So let me add one more line, console dot read key, to stop the crisp screen. Now let me execute this code. If you can see, first the name is Kadir and the second variable value is 70. So this is the output of the program. So I hope, student, you have learned about that how to use the constructor function within the inheritance. And now let's see, again, use the constructor function within the multi-level inheritance. So let me remove this code, or you can say it, comment this code and finish this class and this class before the main function, and start a new class having name is C, and C is connected with the B, and start of the class C. So again, if you can see, we have a class A which is connected with the class B, and class B is connected with the class C. So these three classes is connected with each other. So we will call it as a multi-level inheritance. And in these classes, we have a constructor function. So let's see, again, we have a new class. So we will be creating, again, let me show you that we will be printing a simple message within this constructor. Let's see, C having zero parameter, and within this constructor, console dot write line. This is class C constructor function. Okay, now let's see, create the object for class C, OB is equal assignment operator, then C. So we have just created the class C object, but C is connected with the B. So first it will transfer the control to class B, and at the B class, we have connected a class with the class A. So again, the transfer will control to class A. So A is not connected with any other class. So first, if there are some constructor, by default constructor, the constructor function will be called. Second, if after the executing the execution of the constructor function, it will comes to the class B. And if there are again some constructor, by default constructor function, so that function will be executed. At the end of that function, the control will again comes to the class C. So if there are again we have a constructor function, by default function, it will execute the by default constructor. So let's see the output. But before printing the output, let me again uncomment these two lines. So let's see, again the C constructor is function, then the Kadir is, and then the value of 70 is printed. If you can see, first we have just printed the class C variable, because if you can see, the class C constructor function having a message. So, and class A and B having no message mean they have just printed the initialized some value. So, let me print this value over here, then you will know about class A constructor. And then again print some message over here. Class B. So you have seen last time after the, on the output that constructor C is printed first, because within the class A and class B there was no write line function. So at that time the constructor function just initialize those two variables and then come to the class C and just print the print a simple message. And after the creation of the object, all this happened, and then at the next line they have just printed the name and the marks. So that's why the first message was the constructor function. Now I just use the write line function within the class A constructor function, then again write line function and print a message, and then at the third point we have a same message within the class C. So now let me comment this code so it will be very clarify for you. Let me execute this code. So if you can see, class A is executed, then class B is executed, and at the third time we have a class C constructor is printed. It means the controls again first go to the C class go forward this control to the class B, because class C is connected with the B class and B class is connected with the A class. So A class having a constructor function which is by default. So the message is printed, then the control back to the class B, and class B contains the again the by default constructor, so it also prints a message. And third time we have a class C message. So now let me again uncomment these two lines to be again clarify. So these two messages, as you can say, the value will be printed at the end after the creation of the object. So again class A, class B and class C constructor function, and at the end we have again printed the value which is Kadir and 70. So this is all about the constructor function in inheritance and the constructor function in multi-level inheritance. Student, this is all about today's lecture. If you have any question regarding this topic, you may ask me on my official email address. That is asif@northern.edu.pk. Thank you. Allah Hafiz.